يفنى الكل ويبقى هو ليس الباقي إلا هو. الله 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 ما لي رب إلا هو.
At one time he says that he was so thirsty, his son, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala, his son narrates this incident, that his son says that at one time he hadn't drunk in the jungle, he had no drink and he hadn't eaten for months, and he was extremely thirsty and he was feeling as though if he doesn't have water now then he will feel dizzy and he will fall down. He says he intended to drink water. And he says, as soon as he made that intention in his heart, a cloud came full of water. And this cloud began to give water. Drops of water began to fall. Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala drank from these drops of water that came, this rainwater. He drank from it. And then he says that after he had drunk enough, he says, I saw an amazing light appear all over the sky from that cloud. And I heard the voice that, oh Abdul Qadir, you have worshipped me so much that now I have made everything halal upon you that I have made haram upon everybody else. So Abdul Qadir, you have worshipped me so much that now you have gained such a high status that now everything is halal upon you. You can do what you want and you can eat what you want. You don't have to perform salah. Everything is halal now. Upon that, Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala says, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. I seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the damned shaytan. And he says that, O mal'oon, O cursed one, move away from me now. And Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala says that that light turns into thick, dark, grey or black smoke and it begins to disappear. Whilst it's disappearing, Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala says that he hears the voice saying that, oh Abdul Qadir, today your knowledge has saved you. Today it is your knowledge that has protected you from being misguided. Before you, I have misguided 70 people who were in the path of tariqah, who were walis of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to gain higher statuses. 70 of them, I destroyed their vilayah, I misguided them from the correct path. And oh Abdul Qadir, it is the knowledge that you have that has saved you today. Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala says that it is not my knowledge that has saved me. If it was my knowledge that has saved me, then your knowledge would have saved you from being cursed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You had more knowledge than humans have. And if your knowledge could not save you, then my knowledge cannot save me as well. It is not knowledge that has saved me. It is the fadl, it is the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has saved me from being misguided. From this we learn that it is not knowledge that protects people. Knowledge can misguide people. Today we have many, many great scholars, great amongst their followers, who are known as Shaykhul Islam and whatnot. They have big, big titles and they have lots and lots of knowledge. But are they on the right path? People say that they have so much knowledge. How can they not be on the right path? That knowledge means they are on the right path. Wallahi, that is not the case. By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala, he is giving us a lesson that no people will come who will have a lot of knowledge, but don't think that their knowledge means that they are on the right path. Knowledge is not what keeps you on the right path and protects you on the right path, but knowledge can make you misguided, and shaitan is a perfect example of that. Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala was asked that, Ya Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, how do you know that that was shaitan? At first, how do you know it was shaitan? He says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never make dirty, filthy things halal upon anybody. Allah is pure and Allah is far from such. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khabees cheezo ko kabhi halal nahi farmata. And that is how I knew that that is shaitan. Subhanallah. And Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala in these jungles had moments where he took oath with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he said that, O Allah, I swear by you that I will not eat anything, I will not drink anything. O Allah, I will not drink and I will not eat until you make me eat and drink. And in these in these times, there were times when Shaykh Al-Khalid Jubayr radiallahu ta'ala didn't eat or drink for many, many months. Many, many months. And we can imagine that it is impossible. Science will tell us that it's impossible to stay alive for so long. But these were the saints of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they didn't need material food. They didn't need material drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would feed them without material.
زمین و زمان تمہارے لیے مکین و مکان تمہارے لیے